Eat everything in moderation is advice we hear a lot from diet lifestyle gurus, fitness professionals, physicians, and others. It's a common expression relating to the indulgence or overindulgence of food or drink, you know, the so-called pig out or going off the wagon. And based on my experiences, I disagree entirely. The word moderation is vague, and its vagueness makes it, you know, a friendly big tent kind of concept. However much you eat, you can find a way of convincing yourself that you eat in moderation. And very few chronically dieting, overweight, or obese people can practice an everything in moderation lifestyle, at least not while doing the work for however long it takes to lose weight. Eating something in smaller amounts or less frequently doesn't make it okay, especially when a person knows and their history confirms that it will be a gateway to a full-on nonstop binge. For this person, there is no such thing as moderation when they're in weight loss mode. For this person, everything in moderation is something they use either as an excuse after they've cheated, after they've given in to a loss of willpower, and they feel like shit for having done so, or as a rationale before they indulge to give themselves permission and to save themselves the trouble of coming up with an excuse afterwards. These are the people, most of whom I would analogize to those attending 12-step programs for alcohol, drugs, or gambling addictions. It is not okay for those in recovery to moderately or ever again indulge in that which consumed them and to which they became addicted, oftentimes at the expense of great loss of businesses, of jobs, of relationships, of family. They just can't do it. They will no doubt every now and then get an urge, you know, to indulge just once in their former bad habits or addictions. I mean, I still get a rare urge for a cigarette, and I stopped smoking in 1980. However, they learn in a structured manner and with accountability to others how to prevent triggers whenever possible, as well as how to deal with them if and when they happen. And dealing means abstaining, fighting through the urge, whether by calling a sponsor, reaching out to a loved one, practicing an exercise learned from a mental health professional, etc. For these people, it always means abstaining. A recovering alcoholic can't have just one drink, a drug addict can't do just one line of coke, and a gambler can't play just one game of poker. Similarly, for those who are chronically overweight or obese, a moderate indulgence is almost always a trigger. A person with a true food addiction will almost never be able to consume their drug of choice in moderation. For this group of people, everything in moderation usually turns into eating everything in the house. For some people, some things are just meant for the never ever category. And that's today's Fat Chat. See you next time.